Welcome to our YouTube channel, Raj Academy. In the previous lecture, we have discussed it of network theorem, of network theory. Gate privacy and gate questions from question number 1 to question number 10. So if you didn't see that lecture, please go to our playlist of gate privacy questions and watch those lectures. And then you can see this lecture. So now we will start from our 11th question. So let's get started. Okay, this is the 11th question. In this question, there is a voltage E and in this circuit is given. In this circuit, there is a 2 ampere flowing through 4 ohm. So, in this question, we have to figure the value of the E and figure the value of the I. This question is given by Gate 1997 for 2 marks. So, let's get started. Here, these 2 4 ohm and 1 ohm are parallel. So, the voltage drop across both of them will be same. So let me consider this is a voltage drop. Let me consider it is a V. So as I know the resistors and the current, so that I can easily find out the voltage drop across the resistor across the 4. So V is equal to resistor is 4 and the current is 2. So 4 into 2. So 8 volt. 8 volt is the drop across the 4. Similarly, the 1 ohm is also having the same voltage drop. So let me consider this is a current I1. So, V is equal to 1 into I1. So, V is always, already we got 8. So, 8 is equal to I1. So, I1 is equal to 8 ampere. So, one parameter we got already. So, I1 is equal to 8 ampere. Now, let me consider this as I2. By KCL, sum of incoming currents is equal to sum of outgoing currents. So, as per KCL here, I2 incoming current is equal to outgoing 2 plus I1. So, I1 already we got 8 ampere. So, 8 plus 2 is 10 ampere. So, I2 is equal to 10 ampere. So, now let me consider there is a voltage drop across 6 ohm as some V1. Let me draw a KVL. I will take this loop as a KVL. By taking this loop, I will figure out the value of V1 because the remaining things are already known. So by KVL, as I am going from low potential to high potential, there is a potential rise. That's why we have to take it as a plus V1. And from the current always goes from high potential to low potential. As I am passing from high potential to low potential, there is a potential drop. That's why we have to take an I2. I2 into 1. So I2. So here, I am going from positive to negative, so there is a potential drop. So minus V is equal to 0. So V1, I2 is 10 ampere, and V is already we know. V is how much? 8 volt. So 8 is equal to 0. So V1 is equal to 18. So V1 is equal to 18 volt. So now, as across 6 ohm, we know the voltage, we know the resistor. So we can easily find out the current through the 6 ohm resistance. So let me consider this as some I3. So I3. So V1 is equal to 6 into I3. So V1 is how much? 8 is equal to 6 into I3. So I3 is how much? 18 plus 6. 3 ampere. So I3 is equal to 3 ampere. So across this node, the sum of incoming currents is equal to sum of outgoing currents. So the incoming currents is I. Outgoing currents are I3 and I2. I3 plus I2. So I3 is 3 ampere. And I2 is 10 ampere. So the total I is equal to 13 ampere. 13 ampere is the current. So one parameter we got. One parameter is how much? V is equal to 13 ampere. So the remaining other parameter we have to find. So same procedure. Again use the KVL. By using KVL, these parameters we already know. By using these parameters, we have to find the unknown parameter. That is our main agenda. So by KVL, I am going from low potential to high potential. So there is a potential rise. And from Aurel's belt goes from high pressure to low pressure. So even I am also traveling from high pressure to low pressure, there is a potential drop. So minus I into 1, so minus I. Again, I am going from high pressure to low pressure, so there is a potential drop. So minus V1 is equal to 0. I is 13 ampere. And V1 is how much? V1 is 8. So if you do this, how much will you get? 8. So 31 volt. So this is 31, that's it. So by this simple procedure, we got the value of E and we got the value of I. There are so many other ways also we can do this problem. Okay. Now we go for the next example problem. In this new question, they given that there is a series circuit which consists of resistor and inductor, and there is a supply voltage source which having voltage and frequency. The voltage and the frequency are the constant variables. And by the circuit, there is a current drawn by the circuit. In the circuit, they give that there is a resistance which is a variable which is going from R0 to infinity. When R goes from 0 to infinity, they are asking what is the diameter of the loci. This question is given in gate 1998 for 1 mark. So let us solve this question and find out the result. So the circuit, you know, V is equal to I into Z. So Z is a R plus Jx, because they are in the alternate series, R plus Jx. So we need the value of current I, right? So I is equal to V by J. So I is equal to V by J. So V is V by Z is how much? R plus Jx, right? R plus Jx. So I need to know this is the rectangle form. I need to write this is also rectangle form. Let us assume that V is equal to some V angle 0. We can write like this, right? V angle 0. Now I am writing all this numerator and denominator polar form. So V angle 0 by, now I am writing the magnitude and the angle, right? Magnitude of V, magnitude of R plus Jx is equal to R square plus X square. And the angle. Angle is theta is equal to tan inverse of X by R, right? So tan inverse of X by R. So whenever in polar form, whenever the angle goes up, it will become the negative. So I is equal to V by root over R square plus X square. Here the angle is 0 minus of this. So 0 minus anything is minus same thing, right? Minus tan inverse X by R. Right? Now R is varying from 0 to infinity. So let me assume that when R is equal to 0, we will see what is the value of the current expression. When R is equal to 0, it will become V by 0 square plus X square. So it will become V by root over X square, means V by X, right? So I is equal to V by X. This is the magnitude. And let us see the angle part. As R is 0, anything by 0 is infinity. So non-zero by 0 is infinity. So tan inverse infinity is 90. As there is minus, so you have to keep minus 90 degrees. Right? Let us assume now R is equal to infinity. So when R is infinity, this is a huge value, right? Denominator part is very huge. So the total value will become 0. So magnitude value will become 0. And the angle part is still, when R is infinity, the total part is 0. Then tan inverse of 0 is 0. If it is minus 0 or plus 0, doesn't matter. So we'll write it 0 degrees. So now you will draw the graph. This is the magnitude, this is the angle. So this is a diagram. This is a real part of current. And this is a imaginary part of the current. Right? When R is equal to 0, it is V by X minus 90. V by X means Okay, suppose this length is Vx, it is minus 90 is normal, right? So, I think this is as a minus Vx, this total length as Vx, angle minus 90. And R is equal to infinity, it will become 0 and 0. Let's see here. This is the part. So, it is traveling from this direction. So, like this. So, this, when R is equal to 0, this is a point when R is equal to 0, and this is a point when R is equal to infinity. Okay? So, this is the semicircle. The locus is a semicircle, only half the portion of the circle, that's why it is called as a semicircle. And this is the diameter. And this is the diameter of the semicircle. The diameter is how much length? V by x. So, the diameter of the locus I is V by x. Just see once so that you will understand the concept very well. Okay. Okay, now we will go for the other question, 13th one. In this question, there are three inductors, L1, L2, L3. And this type of problem I have already solved in my first lecture. If you didn't see the first lecture, then please kindly see the first lecture and then come to this lecture. So, three inductors are given. So, in these three inductors, we have to find the net equivalent inductors across the terminals A and B. That is the main important thing that we need to do in this question. And this question is given in the grade 1998 for 2 marks. And inductors values are given for each coil, and mutual inductors between the different coils are also given. So, we need to find the equivalent inductors. That's it. So, as I have already told you, whenever the two inductors connected in series can be connected in two fashions, whether they can be series heading or whether they can be series opposing. So, let's make a note of those two formulas and then we can solve this example so that it will be easy for us to solve this problem. So, these two are series connection, but depending upon the polarity of connection, these two can have different value of inductance. That is a point that you need to be noted in your notebook, in case if you are writing it. I hope you all are writing in the notebook. So, there is a two possibility. The dot, the incoming current is passing, is the current is going into the dotted terminal, and here also the current is going into the dotted terminal. Here, the current is entering the dotted terminal, and here the current is leaving the dotted terminal. Reverse, right? Or there is another possibility also. Here, the two dots can leave. Means the current can leave the dot, and here also the current can leave the dot. So both are incoming, both are incoming, or both are leaving. Here one is incoming and another is outgoing. Or in another way, it can be another possibility, right? Like here it is incoming, right? So it can be outgoing, and here it can be incoming. So, the current is outgoing the dotted terminal and incoming to the dotted terminal. So, these two cases has the same equation. L equivalent is equal to L1 plus L2, so plus 2M. Because there is a series heading, that's why we have to keep positive. Here, there is a series opposing. So, L equivalent is equal to L1 plus L2 minus 2M. So, with these two formulas, we are now eligible to do this type of problem very easily. So, LAB is equal to, as these three are connected in series, then we can easily write L1 plus L2 plus L3. So, now we need to be very careful regarding the priorities of M1, 2, M2, 3 and M3. Because let us assume this is a current line. See here, the current is entering the dotted terminal between the coil 1 and 2, entering the dotted terminal and leaving the dotted terminal. So there is a series opposition. So that's why you write minus 2 and 1, 2. So coil 1 and 2 is finished. Now let us do 1 and 3. See, the series current is entering the dotted terminal and the current is leaving the dotted terminal of the coil 3. So entering and leaving. Again, there is a series opposition. So minus 2. M13. So 1 and 2, 1 and 3. The remaining one thing is combination is 2 and 3. See, it is leaving the second and leaving the third. So it comes to this category, right? Leaving, leaving. So it just is adding. That's why I am positive. Whenever there is adding, take positive. Whenever there is a opposition, take negative. 2m2g. So then all these values substituting this equation, you will get LAB is equal to 11 Henry. This is our required. LAB is equal to 11 Henry. This is our. Okay, now let's get started with another new problem. What is one? In this question, there are some capacitance, and the aim of this question is to find the equivalent capacitance across the B terminal and the Y terminal. That is CDY. And this question is given in the gate year 1999 for 1 mark question. So let's solve it. And before solving this question, we need to know two basic formulas. What is, when two capacitors are connected in parallel, we need to find the equivalent capacitance value. That is C1 and C2. Then C equivalent is equal to C1 into C2 by, sorry, it is, when two capacitors are in parallel, then C equivalent is equal to C1 plus C2. Okay, C equivalent is equal to C1 plus C2. And similarly, when the two capacitors are in series, the equivalent capacitance is equal to C1 into C2 by C1 plus C2. With these two formulas, we can solve this problem very easily. And by seeing this, it seems to be some difficult, but after rearranging it, it will become very easy for us to solve. And see, this is known and this node is same. Means they are interconnected. So we can bring and join here so that the simplified circuit looks like this. See here carefully. This is the CC. These two are in parallel, these two are in parallel. Right? So it will become like this. It looks very simple now. It becomes very simple. This is what R, this is what B, this is what Y. This is CC. CC and CS. CC and CS. Right? CC and CS. CC and CS. So here, these two are in parallel. These two are in parallel. And the net combination is in series. And the net combination of this is parallel. Right? So this equivalent capacitance is, these two are in parallel. Right? So CC plus CS. And again, these two are in parallel. Right? So again, the combination is CC plus CS. Right? But these two are in series. As they are in series, use these two formulas. C1, C2, C1 plus C2. Then you will become, you will get like this. CC plus CS by 2. And this and this are again parallel. So do addition. So C equivalent is equal to CC plus CS by 2 plus CC. So you will become, so 2 plus 1. 3 CC. Plus CS by 2. This is the required solution. That's it. Okay. Now, we will discuss the another question. 15th one. In this question, there is a half-wave rectified symmetrical square wave. Means, positive portion is given, but the negative portion is clipped off by the circuit. So, in this circuit, we need to find the IM is going to appear. For this waveform, we need to find the IRMS. And this question is given in gate 1999 for 1 mark question. Right? So we need to solve. So there is a shortcut formula in order to do this type of problems very easy amount of time. Right? So let me assume this is a T1. This T2 is a, let me assume the T1 and this is a T. So easy formula is IRMS. For these square waves, easy formula is IRMS is equal to IM into root 2 over T on by T. Right? IM is how much here? 2 ampere. Right? Root over TR is how much? Q into. Right? It is given. T on is Q into and the total time is T. So 2 be cancelled and 2 by root 2 is root 2 also. So IRMS is 2 root 2 ampere. This is the answer for this question. Okay. Now, let us discuss this new question 16:1. And this question is very beautiful. Please listen this question with very concentration. So, there is a parallel branch. This is a series, and these two combinations become a parallel branch. So, the resistance is varying from 0 to infinity. And the aim of this question is to figure out the admittance across the A and B terminals, diameter and the center when R is varying from 0 to infinity. And this question is asked in 1999 for 2 marks. So, let us solve this question very carefully. So, we know this is a parallel branch, right? So, 1 by Z equivalent is ZAB. 1 by ZAB is equal to 1 by Z1 plus 1 by Z2 because they are parallel, right? So, 1 by Z1 is 1, Z1 is minus J 0.02 plus Z2 is R plus J 0.01. So this is 1 by ZAB. 1 by ZAB we can also write as admittance. This is impedance. So 1 by ZAB is admittance. This is impedance and this is admittance. 1 by ZAB. So now I want to rationalize this one. I want to rationalize this one. Means I can try to explain. So R minus J 0.01 by R minus J 0.01. So if I do the simplification, finally I will give an expression YAB is the expression which I get is after R by R square plus 0.01 whole square, right? Plus J 50 minus 50 minus 0.01 by R square plus 0.01 whole square. This is the expression which I get after rationalizing and adding these two terms. So now please be carefully. R is, let us assume R is equal to 0. As R is varying from 0 to infinity. Now I will assume when R is equal to 0, what will happen to YAB? When R is equal to 0, YAB, say it is 0. 0 by anything is 0, right? So here it is 0. So 0.01 by 0.01 whole square means 1 by 0.01. It will become, when it goes up, it will become 100. So 50 minus 100 is minus 50, right? So it is minus 50J. Minus 50J, I can write in, this is a rectangular form. Now I can write in polar form like 50 angle minus 90 degree, right? Now I'll consider the other case. Let R is equal to 0.01. So what will happen? Let us see. Then YAB will become, if you substitute this R is equal to 0.01 in this whole categories, you will get 50. Right? You will get around 50. So 50, this is a rectangle and polar form also same. 50 plus J0. J0. Means I can write 50 angle 0. So now I will consider the other case. R is equal to infinity. See here. This is infinity and this is infinity square. Infinity square is very much larger than infinity. So the whole thing will become 0. So it is gone. Now see here. This denominator part is very big. So small thing, this is big thing. Numerator is very small, denominator is very large. So the whole thing will become 0. So the overall thing is the remaining part is only 50J. So YAB is equal to 50J. This is a rectangle form. Now I can write in polar form as 50 and 90. Right? Now with these three, I can draw the graph of, all these three points like this. See here. This is a plot. In this plot, this is what real part of YAB and this is imaginary part of YAB. Right? See here, when R is equal to 0, this 50 at minus 50 at minus 10. This is minus 50. Right? This is minus 50. So, when this is when R is equal to 0. Now, when R is equal to 0.01, it's 50 angle 0. What's here? The point here. Right? When R is equal to 0.01. Now, see here, when R is equal to infinity, YAB is 50 angle 90, right? What's here? 50J. It's 50J. Minus 50J. Right? When R is equal to infinity. So, R is going from 0 to 0.1, 0.2 to infinity. So, the whole locus will be like this. It's going from like this. So, what is the diameter? This is the center. Center of the circuit. Because the radius is 50, 50, 50. The total diameter is 100J. So, what is the diameter? Diameter is equal to 100J. And the center is equal to 0, 0. Which is the origin. This is the thing which we got found out from this example. Okay, this is the new question. 7.1. This is a very easy question, but even then we will solve it. So please kindly concentrate. So this is a circuit. In this circuit, there is an ideal current source. For this current source, there is a resistor R. In this condition, the resistor is consuming the power of 18 watt. And here there is another circuit. In the circuit, there is a voltage and the same resistor is connected to a real voltage source. In this, the resistor is absorbing a power of 4.5 watt. And the given condition is this I and this V are both equal. These are given the question. So we need to figure out the what is the value of the current I and the what is the value of the resistors R by these two circuits. And this question is given the gate 1999 for 2 marks. So let's solve this problem. We know the power across the resistor is V in voltage across the resistor or current across the and the current in the resistor. Or you can write like this is V squared by R or I squared by I squared into R. So these three formulas are suitable for the resistor. Right? So now see here, this is the current I. And it also possesses the resistor and it also goes through the current source. So the power absorbed by the resistor is I square R, I square into R. So I square into R is equal to 18 watt. So I square into R is equal to 18. This is the first equation. Now let's come here. In this, the voltage across the resistor is R. So we can use this formula, right? Can use this formula. So power across the resistance V squared by R is equal to 4.5 watt. But here they are given that V is equal to I, right? So in place of V, I am going to flex I. So I squared by R is equal to 4.5. So this is a there is a one equation, this is the other equation. By two by there are two equations and there are two unknowns. The two unknowns are I and R. So by these two equations with two unknowns, we can simplify this and we will get the current I is equal to 3 ampere and the resistor R is equal to 2. So by simplifying these two equations, we can get the value of the current I is equal to 3 ampere and the value of the resistor is R is 2. So, that's it for this question. Okay, now let us solve the other new question. In this question, they are given that there are three branches that are meeting at a particular node. So, all these currents are incoming. And in this, I1 and I2 are given, and we need to figure out the value of the current I3. And this question is given the gate 1999 for 2 marks. So, in order to solve this example, you need to know these two things. Cos theta is equal to sin 90 plus theta. And sin theta is equal to minus of cos 90 plus theta. So, I will just give you a brief how to remember also. All silver tea cups. It means here all are positive. Here only sine and sine inverse is possible. Only these are positive and in this T means tan and cut are only positive, remaining are negative. Cups means C. C means cos, cos reverse is cosine. Sec. Only these are positive, the remaining all are negative. See, here sin 90 plus theta. Sin 90 plus theta means here. Here sin is positive. That's why positive. And there is a 90, right? Odd number. Means whenever there is a 90 or cos 90, then sin changes to cos. And whenever there is a 180 and 360, then sin doesn't change. Sin changes to sin or cos changes to cos. That's it. Okay? See here. Cos 90 plus theta. Cos 90 plus theta. Here in this cos is neutral. So that's why neutral can shift it here. So sin theta. As there is a 90, so cos changes to sin. Reverse. So these things you need to hold on in order to solve this problem. So now let's go to solve the main problem, which came through. By KCL, the sum of incoming currents is 0. So I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to 0. We need to figure out the value of I3. So I3 is equal to minus of I1 plus I2. So if you substitute this one, you will get minus of minus positive 6 sin omega t minus 8 cos omega 2. Now I will take sin as reference. So I need to change cos to sin. So cos can change to sin only when cos is equal to sin of 90 plus theta. So I need to write like this 6 sin omega t minus 8 inverse of cos. I need to write sin 90 plus sin 90 plus omega t. Okay. Now I can write like this, right? This is 6 angle 0. This is 8 angle 90. If I take sin as reference, I will take angle 0. Here, this plus 90, right? So that's plus 90. If you do this one, you will get around I3. You will get 10 angle. You calculate if you do minus 53. Part 13. You will get like this. Minus 53 part 13. So now I will convert to like this. Now I will convert back here 10 sine omega t minus 53 part 13. Because this is what sine I have taken already reference, so I convert it back to sine. Suppose I want to convert to cos. Then what I should do? Then I3 is equal to, as you know already, sin can change to cos when sin must be minus cos of 90 plus theta. So you would write in place of this, you would write minus 10 cos of omega t minus 53.30 plus 90. Now I3 is equal to minus 10 cos omega t plus 90 minus 53. For 30, you will get like 36.87. So, anything, this can be a solution or this can be a solution. Based on the options, you can click either this option or this option. We can convert from sine to cos or cos to sine. If you take sine, then replace the answer in sine. If you take cos as reference, then replace the answer in cos. Okay. Now, let's go for the new question. In this question, the question says that there is a circuit. In the circuit, we need to find the equivalent resistance across the RAB. Means the circuit looks how much resistance it has across this RAB. We need to find. This question is given in the gate 2002 marks. This circuit is called as a digit circuit because in this circuit there is no independent sources. There is only dependent sources. Or a dependent source which is there and there is no independent source. That is why this circuit is called as a dead circuit. Again, I will repeat, a circuit which doesn't have any independent source is called as a dead circuit. So, to find RAB, we need to do some procedure. The procedure is, first, we need to supply a voltage. supply any voltage. Let I assume it is a voltage V and there is a current I. So I need to figure out, let I assume this is a zero potential. Now there is only one node. This node voltage is V. By node analysis, the outgoing currents, the sum of outgoing currents is equal to G. So by case here, in this one, so outgoing is incoming is I, so outgoing is minus I. Plus outgoing current is this one is V by V minus 0 by 4. Plus the outgoing current is V minus 2I by 2 is equal to 0. So I will write in easy fashion, minus I plus V by 4 plus V minus 2I by 2 is equal to 0. Right? If you simplify this circuit, V by, if you simplify this equation, V by I is equal to, you will get 8 by 3. This is what I need. This is what I repeat. Means the whole circuit now is equivalent to a voltage P and a current is coming and there is a resistor. How much? 8 by 3. So the whole circuit is now simplified to a simple circuit with equivalent resistance of R by 3. So this is the resistance which is seen across the terminals A and B. So this is a dead circuit equivalent resistance. Okay. Numerical in this video lecture. So please focus concentratedly. So in this circuit, there is a transformer. This is one circuit and this is another circuit. These two circuits are combined by a transformer. In the middle, there is a transformer. So in this question, they are asking to find the equivalent impedance seen by this voltage source. That is what they are asking. And the turns ratio N1 and N2 are 1 by 4. 1 is to 4. And this question is given the get 2000 photo marks. So we need to figure out what is the equivalent impedance seen by the voltage source. That is our main agenda in this problem. So let's get started to solve this problem. See, whenever there is a interchange, transferring of impedance from secondary to primary, there is always, we need to include the Z equivalent is of primary, say first write the same terms, right? Don't change anything in the first primary side, minus J2. But when you are including from secondary to primary, always use primary by secondary terms ratio N1 by N2 whole square plus whole square into is Zn. Means now it will become plus 4 minus 2j plus n1 is 1 and n2 is 4. So 1 by 4 whole square into Zn is 10 angle 30. So if you do simplification, you will get answer Z equivalent is equal to, you will get answer Z equivalent is equal to 4.54 minus J under J 1.69. This is the equivalent impedance seen by this voltage source. Means this whole circuit can be equivalently represented as like this. This is the voltage source. This is the voltage source Vs, and we are represented in an equivalent bias of J equivalent. Means the current drawn by this circuit and this circuit is same. There is no change. The current drawn by this circuit and the current drawn by the simplified circuit, both are remain the same. That is the meaning of the simplified circuit. Today we discussed about the 10 questions in this video lecture. So please kindly note all these questions in a separate notebook, so that it will be very useful when you are preparing for any examination, so that it will become a very easy revision for you. So that is why I am particularly mentioning, please write in a separate notebook. And one more thing is, if there is any improvement if needed in this video lectures, then please comment in the comment section, so that I will read each and every comment and I will rectify myself in order to get better myself, so that all the students get benefited from this video lectures. So please kindly inform us And if you like this video lecture, please like and please share and please subscribe this channel so that we will get motivation to do more like these videos. And thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much.